Hi guys, how's it going? Today's video is gonna be all about this little bad boy, the 24 to 105, and I'm gonna show you why this lens should always be attached to your camera when you're moving around. And secondly, why this is a great lens for portraits and shooting people. There's so much this lens can do, so let's get started. Okay, so why is it that I'm saying that this one should always be attached to your camera when you're moving around? For once, you will always be ready and you will be able to catch most things thrown in front of you while traveling and moving around with this lens. Let me show you some examples. I'm at a lake in the Lago di Dabi Dubi. Everything's in place, but you need the focal point. So I was looking for birds, I was looking for a boat or something, and then all of a sudden this swan comes swimming and it moves and I'm moving to catch it directly between the reflection of the mountains. Had I had a 16 to 35 here, I would not have been able to make this kind of photo. Here I've zoomed in to 52 millimeter and that seems like the perfect range for catching a moment like this. Here at the Faroe Islands, the low hanging clouds along the cliffs are really, really nice, but I was like looking for a focal point here. And all of a sudden this girl, which I don't know, she walks into my frame and I'm just handholding the shot and shooting it at 62 millimeter. Again, had I had a 16 to 35 millimeter, I could have never achieved this exact kind of photo. Second image here from the Faroe Islands. I was hiking on my way out to Drangarnir, and all of a sudden these two sheep, they are standing right in front of me and they're just looking at me. I knew I had like a split second to make this shot because maybe they would be scared and they would run off. So what I did was to stop, get my camera very slowly, zoom into, in this case, to 68 millimeter, which was like perfect to frame these two very cute animals in front of this very iconic background. And I was totally right. Once I started to zoom out to maybe 24 millimeter and move closer, they turned around and they started to run away from me, and that photo was gone forever. Same with this one. Here I'm zoomed into 80 millimeter, and again, had I gone closer to this and shot like a 24 or 16 or something, it would have ran away from me, so I would not have been able to get this shot. The light can be gone, the subject can be gone, like so many things in photography can be gone in seconds, so that's why you just want to be able to shoot right away when you see something. Also, this next photo here, all of a sudden the light breaks through the clouds, and it was, I'm telling you, this light was only here for like 10 seconds. So had I not had this one on, let's say I had a really wide angle, or I had like a 70-200 or something, and I would have to change back to this kind of focal length to catch it, it would have been gone. I would have missed it, and I would have hated to have missed a moment like this. The light sometimes peeks through so very fast and it disappears just as fast. So this was like the briefest of moments, and I could only catch something like this because I had this lens on. And of course, also when I'm driving my car, I always have the camera next to me on the other seat, because I know whatever I will meet, whatever kind of light or whatever horse or anything that will just, you know, pop in front of me when I'm driving, I'll be able to catch with this lens. Here I'm in Kenya. This was a magical morning. We woke up very early and dark and we drove out into the savannah, and then all this fog was there and it was amazing. So everything was in place, the light was right, the fog was right, the setting, the trees, everything looked amazing. And then all of a sudden we find this group of, there's actually four cubs of lions playing around. In this shot there's only three, but there's a fourth one running around. Some of the best shots on this session was shot with this 24 to 105. It's just nice to be able to go to like 24 and get the whole scene in and not be sit in the car and be fiddling around and shifting lenses. And because we all know that when you don't have a lens on your camera, you're not taking any photographs and therefore you are missing shots. Here again, a group of elephants standing and eating. It's very nice to be able to go from 105 to 62 in a matter of seconds, because these two photos are taking very, very closely together. It's like there's no matter than there's maybe a minute between these two. You can actually see there's a lion standing in the background in the right side of this photo because it's shot at the same time. So to be able to shoot 105 with the lions and then just go over here and be shooting 24, 35, 62 in this case, and get this scene of the animals feeding and eating the leaves of the trees. For me, that is just the ultimate freedom in photography, and that's what you want. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you a few examples of using a lens like this when you're traveling to get people shot, to get portraits, to catch moments of random people you meet in the street. And when I saw these two boys with these rifles, I just knew I had to take a photograph of them. So I asked them to get into the tent because the outside, it was in the middle of the day, we were driving. I just saw them standing with the rifles next to the tent. And I said to my driver, let's stop the car. I have to go and talk to these guys. Outside was super bright, but placing them inside the tent made the light very, very beautiful. And normally I don't ask too much for posing, but in this case, I just said, please hold your rifles the same way you did before. Just stand there. This one again, also from Iran. Driving along the road, seeing two herders, which turned out to be two brothers, tending the herders, keeping an eye on the sheep. I just stopped the car and I ran out. Please just stay where you are. Maybe the shot would have been better at 24. Maybe the shot would have been better at 50. But stepping out of the car, grabbing my camera with this lens on, I knew that whatever would be best, I would have that focal length. You'd need to be able to just stop the car, get right out and take the shot. And not standing around and thinking too much about what to do here. Just get the shot. And my experience is that if you have this one attached to your camera, when you're driving around, when you're moving around, you will always be able to go out and get a really nice shot right away. And that's what photography is all about. Because we all know that these moments, they disappear so fast when we interact and when we stop the car and get out. So be ready to get those authentic moments. This is a portrait. She was actually the little sister to the boys with the rifles before. And then when you stand people like in the shadow, in front of a dark background, kind of sometimes it's just like the perfect conditions for portraits, because you have this beautiful natural light, which is like indirect. It can almost look like a portrait that is shot in a studio sometimes. It's so beautiful. I kind of really love that. Maybe I should do a whole video about making portraits in those kind of, and using like indirect natural light, because it's such, it can be such a beautiful thing. Shooting around 100 millimeter is really, really nice for portraits. Try and shoot way more portraits from 85 to 105. In that range, you can make some really beautiful stuff. So remember that. Here's another shot from Iran. Again, you're walking around at this viewpoint in Tehran, which is this giant city. And all of a sudden, you spot a scene like this. These three men just sitting there in the sunset. It's not a peaceful place. But this photograph is peaceful. And it's peaceful because I was able to grab it before these men, they knew I was there. So I was like going behind them and I was zooming into 44 millimeter in this case, I can see, and just taking a few snaps. And when they heard the click, they were like, they turned around and they wanted to, oh, whoa, hi, how are you? And who are you? And I sat down and I talked to them. But because I did it the other way around, this is maybe a bonus tip. When you're doing like travel and street photography, you need to take the shot when you see it. Always take the shot first, and then you can ask afterwards if it's okay. If you ask first, the moment is gone. The situation is gone, the photograph is gone. So always take the shot and then go and talk to people afterwards. This is another example of this lens, just a beautiful, great lens to shoot people. This is shot on 35mm. It's in Kyrgyzstan. It's in a market. Such a peaceful, quiet moment. They were having tea and they were having this traditional bread. The colors was the reason why I was drawn to this. When people are sitting inside a cafe and it's like a more intimate situation, you should have more courtesy. And in this case, I went and I got a permission from this couple to take a photograph of them. Here, I'm just gonna show you a few examples of random travel stuff shot with this lens and why it was important to have this lens on. I hear it from so many photographers that, it's so boring, 50mm, it's just what the eye see, and people think it's boring. So that's why people, they are going very wide, like 60mm, or they're going like 200 or 400mm, very, very close in. I just have to disagree that photographing around 40, 50, 60mm is boring. I think you can make some beautiful stuff in that, because you're compressing the scene a little bit and it's very natural here in this scene from Yosemite. Some people might look at this and think, oh, that's a telephoto lens. That must be at least 70 to 200 because it looks so compressed. You get all these layers in the photograph. But this is exactly what I mean by, you know, shooting with this. This is shot on 105. And that's often enough, you know. You don't always need to have a 70 to 200 or a 100 to 400 to catch a scene like this. Having this is what you need. I shoot a lot on 105. I love this photograph. The morning light, the mist, everything is just, yeah. 105mm, who would have thought? This is a very new shot and I decided to shoot this on 35mm. And why didn't I just shoot this on 16 or 24 or something? What happens when you shoot very wide is that the background of the photograph always becomes very small. But by compressing things a little bit more and going higher up, maybe shooting at 50 or 70, you're giving more power to the background or the mountains, so they become bigger in the image. And that makes for a more interesting photograph to look at. We're getting to the end, and I'm just showing you one more technique where this lens is really, really handy. You are actually able to make very wide shots with this lens. You just need to use a technique of stitching together several photos. So what I did in this shot was I was taking six individual shots vertical, across the whole scene, and then I was stitching them together in Lightroom afterwards. Very difficult for me to say, stitching them together. And it's very easy actually to stitch images together in Lightroom. I'll probably make a tutorial about that in a later episode. All right, guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed my views on the 24 to 105. And if you like this video, I would highly appreciate a like. And please comment below as well, what's your favorite lens for when you're moving around and doing travel photography? And remember as well to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell to make sure you're never going to miss any upload of mine. I will see you in next week's video. Take care. Bye-bye.